Have you noticed that some old, not so good habits have slowly slipped back in? And now your waistline or energy levels are starting to show the signs. You're not alone. Hi, I'm Jenny and I'm a midlife nutrition and habit coach. And yes, I too have let my habits slip a little this summer. I've had a great summer full of travel, boat days on the lake, and a more relaxed schedule. But I'm starting to feel the effects. In today's video, I'm sharing exactly what I'm going to do to kind of do a little reboot in hopes that might inspire you to do the same and also to keep me accountable. And don't worry, it's not a crash diet. First one is different for each of us, but that one food that used to feel like a treat, but then you're finding ways to incorporate it every day or most days and it's slowly crept back in. It's really no longer a treat, but you know it's not serving your body. For me, that is sugar. I have slowly let it creep back in. Traveling, being on the boat, lots of different opportunities to have sugar. And I found more reasons to celebrate with it over the summer. And I know it doesn't make me feel good. It makes my energy crash. It makes me put on some weight around the middle. I know sugar doesn't do well for me. So instead of cutting cold turkey, I am going to decide in advance one day a week that I get to enjoy it. The rest of the week I can go sugar free. And I know I feel so much better when I do this, so I know I just have to get the momentum. But allowing myself to have that one day where I get to enjoy that food makes it feel less restrictive and me being more in control. So what's that one food? Maybe it's sugar, maybe it's alcohol, maybe it's gluten or dairy, something that you know has just crept back in that isn't really making you feel your best. Try to decide in advance how many times you're gonna enjoy it and when you're gonna enjoy it, and the rest of the week, abstain from it. The second thing I'm gonna do is be more mindful. Now, I teach my clients this all the time. I tell you on these videos about being mindful when you eat. In the fun and celebration mode of summer, I've kind of let that slip. And instead of being mindful, I slip back into my eating too fast and cleaning my plate before I realized I've even done that, just overeating a little bit. So at times I was mindful, but I didn't do it on a more regular basis. So from now on, I'm going to really practice putting my feet down before I sit down for a meal and being where my feet are, mindfully eating, trying to eat a little bit slower, chew more, continuing to put my fork down and ask myself, am I still hungry? Or would I be satisfied to just stop right now? And really trying to pay attention to the hunger cues. I also will do this by putting less on my plate and creating that pause to go get seconds, so I'll be more mindful. This doesn't feel restrictive because it's really just satisfying your hunger with just enough. I heard the saying, never starving, never stuffed. Well, I want to be in that middle range where I'm not starving, but I'm not stuffed. So I'm going to work on mindful eating. Want to know the easy way to get those habits on autopilot? Download my free habit guide and I'll show you the easy way. Number three, with the summer, more relaxed schedule, traveling with my husband, being on the boat, snacks have snuck their way back in. And I'm relying on, even though they're healthy, snacks to get me through them from meal to meal. I know snacks aren't helping my waistline or my energy, because every time you eat, your blood sugar goes up and then it must come down. And when it comes down, you have an energy slump. Those snacks are also keeping you from going into fat burning mode. So I know I need to be less snacky. So instead of totally cutting out snacks altogether, when I'm hungry in the afternoon, and I'm gonna really see if I'm hungry or if it's just a habit, instead of getting all the snacks, even if they're healthy, I'm gonna drink a cup of bone broth slowly. Now I know this might sound gross to you, but it does take some getting used to. But bone broth is great for protein, it's great for your gut health, and it can become kind of a slow ritual that feels like a treat as you get used to it. I like the taste of bone broth. We drink it after we've traveled to kind of reduce some inflammation. I'm gonna make this more of a regular part of my afternoon to ditch the snacks that aren't serving me and do something that's a little bit more healing for me. So bone broth is my third habit. Habit number four, I've kind of gotten out of the habit because it's been so dang hot. Here in Texas, we're in the hundreds most days. It's really hot and it takes a lot out of you. But I know the importance of taking a walk right after a meal. A walk after a meal helps lower the blood sugar impact of that meal, gives you a little energy, helps you enjoy the evening more, gets my step count back up. So I'm gonna be intentional about taking a walk. And 5 minutes in the heat is not gonna kill me. I also like it as kind of a wind down to the end of the day, kind of recenter myself. It gives me a little extra energy to make it through till bedtime. If Brady goes with me, I love to just for us to discuss how our day went, kind of reconnect. And if you can do it as the sun's setting, even better. It really helps set your circadian rhythm for sleep as well. So that's my challenge, is to find most days walking after dinner. When you do that, it helps lower that blood sugar impact, which will help with your weight and your energy. The next one, with our travel schedule, different things going on during the summer, I was throwing away produce more often than we were finally getting to finish it. So I kind of slowly got away from eating my leafy greens, but that's gonna change. I'm gonna start getting back on to eating those leafy greens before I eat lunch and dinner. That helps lower blood sugar impact. As I keep telling you, it helps add colors to my diet. It's just all around a good thing to do. So I'm gonna be eating leafy greens before lunch and dinner. An easy way to sneak these in is to chop them up and put them on the bottom of your plate and then put whatever you're eating on top. It can be a great just appetizer to have a small side salad. This really can start making a difference, and you can fill up on the good stuff before you get to the high carbs. That's gonna help you drop some of that weight, manage that blood sugar and your energy level. And I don't mean like a boring salad like you'd order at the restaurant. If you're at a restaurant, that'll do, but at home, chop up some leafy greens, put some fresh fruit in there, some nuts, seeds, your favorite dressing. Make that salad feel like a treat, because it actually is a treat for your body. And if you don't like salad, you don't have to start there. Start with a veggie tray before each meal. Eat some kind of vegetable, one or two bites at the bare minimum, just before you eat the rest of your meal, and you're gonna start to notice a difference. It's a good way to sneak in those vegetables. Now, this next one is empty nesters who like to travel and don't have kids at home. We tend to, in the summer, eat out a little bit more. So that's my next habit I'm gonna work on, is eating at home more often. I love to eat out, and you can still eat healthy there, but it's hard to avoid some of those inflammatory oils that most restaurants use. And the portions are bigger. You can get more bang for your buck when you eat at home, and I think you can eat tastier food when you eat at home and can control the ingredients. And I don't know about you, but I'm kind of tired of eating with all the distractions of the TVs and people on their phones. I like a more intimate, quiet dinner at home. I can be more mindful about how I'm eating. It's just a more relaxing experience, I think. And if you don't know some quick meals to do, stay tuned till tomorrow, and I'm gonna show you three of my favorite meals that take minimal time to pop in the oven, and you'll enjoy a healthy but delicious meal. Now this last one, in the summertime, it's so easy to let that bedtime slip a little later and later. The sun's staying out longer, you're doing fun things, maybe you're traveling, you're eating out later, or you were just watching the Olympics like we were for the last 2 weeks. All of that kind of made our bedtime slip a little bit later. Now I get up at the same time no matter what, thank you menopause or something, but when my bedtime slips, I don't get enough time to get good quality sleep. And when you don't sleep good, you want those snacky foods. You don't make as good a choice as you're too tired to exercise like you should. All of those things get compounded. I'm gonna pretend like we're starting back to school and we're getting a regular bedtime again, so I can get that good quality sleep and have the energy and the motivation to stay strong on the rest of these habits. If summer has let your healthy habits slip a little, don't worry. You can get back on track little by little. Pick one of these habits to work on and just start putting in the reps. Let me know in the comments which one you're gonna work on first so I can cheer you on. Don't forget to subscribe if you need more inspiration to make your midlife your best life.